How you doing, Nathan?
Good, yourself?
Doing well. Congratulations. Can you just I guess tell us one, how you're feeling about signing with the Saints, and two, what roles you've played in the past and that you feel like you're gonna play for the Saints?
To start off, being able to sign is definitely a great opportunity. Definitely a sign of relief, feelings of relief just to see that my hard work's continue to pay off. Definitely excited to get down there and get to work. As for specific roles that I've played before in the past, I guess a lot of people know me for my run stopping ability and stuff like that, but I'm definitely able to get after the passer.
Hey, you've had somewhat of a non-traditional path leading back to college. What did that teach you, what you went through in college?
My biggest thing was just perseverance and delayed gratification. Those were two things that I knew with my path I was not going to, or I would have to come to terms with on a daily basis for sure. So being able to just continue to grind, put my head down and wait for my opportunity, didn't know where it was coming all the time, but sometimes I think that makes for the best case scenario. Because you always have to be ready.
Nathan, when you came together for the Saints, was there anything in particular that stood out, whether it was Dennis Allen or Todd Grantham or anything, meeting with them? What it really specifically attracted you about the Saints?
I think what attracted me most was just the increased opportunity. I went through free agency last year, and they definitely showed some interest then. It just wasn't the right fit at the time, but for them to come back this year with the needs that they do have on defense, it's just very, very obvious, very strong offer, and I was more than happy to oblige.
Nathan, how much do you know about this defensive line and the style of play that they want to play and have played?
Definitely, I know that their entire defense, not just the defensive line, but their entire defense, there's a standard. There's a standard when it comes to the Saints. It's definitely one of the strengths of their entire team. And that's, again, just another reason why I'm excited to be there.
You used the word opportunity earlier. How much do you weigh opportunity and there being an opening, because the Saints did lose two defensive tackles before you signed, but also joining a team that's already top notch? You know what I mean? Like balancing where you can play right away versus competing for a spot.
Well, I mean, I'm of the belief that there's always competition. Even if you don't see it, there's always competition. From the moment you sign on the dotted line, there's always competition. Whether that person is in the building, not in the building, whatever it is, it's, you know, about you coming in and being at your best. That's my mentality coming in, going in. And I understand that that's what, you know, other players in that locker room are also feeling. And I believe that adds to our overall success.
Nathan, what was it like for you growing up in Ajax, Ontario? You ended up at Simon Fraser University. What was it like playing football there? And how did you end up at Fort Hays State?
Growing up, Ajax in Canada, it was just home. It was, for me, it was just an opportunity to come play ball, win high school, things like that. I guess what I did see about the U.S. is just how much more developed their resources are towards football, funding, programming, things like that. So those were things that I kind of had to go without being in Ajax. There was a lot more private ball as opposed to playing in high school. So when I was able to finally get a scholarship at Simon Fraser, great opportunity, really excited about that. I was there for 2 years. It eventually didn't end up being the right fit for me and things that I wanted. There's a few things that were lacking. I still, to this day, believe that the best opportunities for athletes are going to be in U.S. programming, just because it's just so much further developed and far along. So eventually, it was just in my best interest to leave the program and try to find a way to get to a U.S. program.
Who recruited you then at Fort Hays State? Who was the coach at the time?
Wide receiver coach Al McCray. Al McCray, He and I go way back. I actually just talked to him not too long ago, because we definitely still stay in touch. But he was the person who originally recruited me, and then actually kind of helped me through the whole NFL process my senior year.
Anything else?
Oh, one more. What are some strengths that you feel you bring to the team and like your selling point?
Definitely. You know, people have talked about my ability, just my stoutness in the run game. And, you know, that's something I definitely pride myself in. That's something I enjoy to do, and the ability to contribute for sure. But aside from that, probably my mindset, how I approach taking care of my body, how I approach preparation for the game, the way I'm in the locker room, the way I am in the weight room, just my work ethic, because I guess my journey has been different. So it's required a lot of work, it's required a lot of discipline, and it's required a lot of patience in order for me to get here. And that's kind of just what I try to live by when I'm striving for a new goal, really, is to work hard, be patient, and be consistent.